Soft skills are human skills. Soft skills are life skills. Soft skills are fundamental and critical skills. It doesn't matter who you are and where you are in life. Soft skills cut across language. It cuts across boundaries and it cuts across cultures. You don't have to speak English to be able to use soft skills. You don't have to speak any particular language, because soft skills is not only about the words you speak, but about how you present yourself. It's about what you do in the entire process. Every time I talk about soft skills, I'm reminded that it changes you, the human, and it changes who you affect on a daily life. So even though I'm speaking and I'm going to be supporting and adding value to the Ghana Most Beautiful pageant and the contestants on soft skills, I'm going to be able to let you understand that all these soft skills I'm teaching apply to you, and to you. First thing, what soft skills are going to be very critical when you are on stage? Remember, on stage is when you have the presentation. On stage is when you have the public speaking. On stage is when you have that one-on-one engagement that you want to influence someone. And the Ghana Most Beautiful contestants are also going to be on stage. The soft skills I look for are, first, the various intelligences. Everyone thinks that intelligence is only about IQ, which is what you know technically or what you went to school for. No, no, no. There are key intellects that you need to have. Emotional intelligence is one of them. The ability to stand there and be criticized, whether constructively or not, and still have that ability to respond and not react. That is emotional intelligence, is to know yourself and understand others in a way where you can actually speak to them in a controlled manner. People intelligence, being able to connect with people, to be able to tell them what you're thinking in a candid way. They give you the same feedback. They learn from you and you learn from them. The other intelligence that I really love is what we call the social quotient, that ability to connect with each person. It doesn't matter what part of life they are coming from. So I'm going to be looking out for these intelligences. The second thing I'm going to be looking out for is confidence. Everybody sees confidence as something you have to have innately. No, confidence is something you do, and then over time, you become. And that's where people get confidence wrong. Confidence is that ability to be willing to try when others are not. And that's what the Ghana Most Beautiful contestants are doing. Once they have confidence to come into that first stage in their region, that is the start. And confidence is developed over time. Confidence requires patience. It requires attitude. It requires perseverance. So confidence is not a one-time skill. Is an overtime skill. I'm going to be watching and then pushing and then driving it into them bit by bit. My story is a story of lack of self-esteem. I come from a place of a lot of pain where confidence was nowhere in my books. Confidence was not innate to me. I was never a confident person. I always felt lower than the next person, and I never even had the ability to have a voice. All I started with was the willingness to try. And over the years, I developed it. And that is what I help people do on a daily basis. And I want to help the contestants as well. Another thing that I'm going to be looking for very critically is hunger. How much do you want this? It's a human skill. A lot of people think that they reach a stage in life, they don't have hunger anymore. At my age, I still have the hunger, the drive, the ability to keep the momentum going, to start life again, to reinvent, to know that even if you fall, you can rise up and do it again. Over and over and over again, without hunger, you can't do it. The GMB contestants are going to need hunger. Whether they are number one or number 10, they are going to need hunger. One of the things that I'm going to drive out of them and push them to do is to remind themselves that the hunger has to be there for all the 13 weeks of the program. Beyond that, and also in life, these are some of the fundamental soft skills. I'm going to be looking particularly for presence. Presence is not just on stage to be seen. That's easy to do. People will just dress you up and let people look at you. No, it's to have that ability to be engaging, to listen, not only to hear, not panic, but understand what you are being asked and be able to respond. Have the presence of mind, have the presence of stage, have the presence of innovation and the presence of image. The last thing I'm going to be looking for is proposition. What kind of proposition are they sending for the audience and the judges to buy? People are going to be voting for them. And I always tell people that every time you step out, every time you're on stage, every time you have to speak to somebody, you're buying a vote. That vote is a vote of confidence in you. That vote is a vote of trust in you. And it's the same thing I'm going to bring to the Ghana Most Beautiful contestants. I'm going to be looking out for that soft skill of that ability to make a proposition that people will buy, not by the words, but by you as a person. These skills put together will make anyone win in life. And I'm really looking forward to it. Don't forget, it's Sundays at 8 p.m. on TV3.